Welcome. In today's video, we're going to be diving into the MAXX and the MAX DAX function as part of the DAX Made Easy series that we're setting up here. So what we're going to do is fully equip you with the knowledge for how to use these and when to use them and the differences between the MAXX and the MAX. There you go. Let's get into it right now. Let's dive into Power BI. All right. So here we are. What we're gonna first do is look at the definitions, then look at the data, then go through and build these. We're gonna do examples with MAX and MAXX that where they work and then where they don't work. So you learn when to use them and when not to use them. Ultimately, the MAXX you're gonna want to use when we're doing calculations. I'm gonna show that example. But let's just start by looking at the definition up here. I'm gonna turn on the click and the animation so you can see my cursor. We have MAX, it's gonna return, it has two functions really. It's gonna return the largest value in a column holistically or between two expressions. And so I'll show you an example of that. MAXX, it's easier to understand as well if you're confused on it by an example that I'll set up for you, but it's gonna go through and return the highest value that results from evaluating an expression iteratively across every row of a table. That is really important for calculation. So what we're gonna do, the way we're gonna look at that is by trying to understand what the max total sale is for anything. And you'll see how that will work and will not work with different ways. But the goal of this is to teach you these functions. So let's look at the data. If we come into this section here, we have sales data, it's a bunch of orders. And the key thing is that there's an order line, there's a price and a quantity. So in this case, the price is 7, the quantity is 3, the total sale is $21. So what the calculations are gonna do is gonna be revolving around that. Let's first start by creating just a new calculation to show how the MAX function kind of works in action. So I'm gonna say MAX, we'll call this one MAX price equals MAX, and then it's just requiring you to put in a single value. So in this case, I'm gonna go MAX price. And if you're ever curious, when you're in there, it pops up that gray box. So I'm gonna hit enter, and then we're gonna add this. And we'll do the same deal of saying, let's set this to zero formatting so it aligns. But now this is just to show what MAX price is doing. So what it's doing, and I have a grouping and a total set up. So let's first look at the row levels. It's saying at the most granular level, what's the max price, which is this column, 262 of this order. In this case, 262 is correct. And then for furniture, it's taking all of the rows and saying, what's the max price within this section? In this case, it's 4,416. And then it's saying at the total, what's the max price total? And that's gonna be for every row we discuss, which is there's something in there for $22,000. Okay, cool. So that's a great reason and a great way to use MAX. It works correctly. And let's show how MAXX will do that same thing, but then I'll show you what MAX won't do and what MAXX will do. So just to get the gist for how to start populating this function, if we do MAXX price equals MAXX, you always start with a table. So again, the gray section says put a table, then put an expression. So we're gonna go sales, and I wanna care about the price. So sales price. Add that. We'll come up to the formatting, change this to zero as well, just for space. And there you go. It's the exact same thing. It returns the same values. It functions exactly the same, which is good. But now I'll show you an example of an intentionally created problem that won't work. And we'll go through the process of how to do it correctly. So now let's say the total sale is calculated over here by taking the price times the quantity. And let's do that to understand what's the max total sale. So if we do it first, I'll do it at a row level, but I'll do it in an incorrect fashion so you just learn more about how these functions don't work. So I'll say max total sale equals, so this max price that we have here, 262, I'll say take the max price times the quantity. And again, this is intentionally designed to be incorrect, just to show you how these things, sometimes doing something wrong will help you see how to do it correctly. We're gonna take the quantity and return this. So this is an expression that evaluate or validates correctly at the row level, but incorrectly at the total. And the goal is to show you how this function's working so you can learn how to do it with max X correctly. Again, let's move these just slightly so it's easier to follow. Move this right here. And I'll just call it total sale. Cool. So if we look over here, this order, number one, one row, the price of it was 262, the quantity was 2, the total sale was 524. So the max of that is also 524, which is represented here. But this is why this calculation was intentionally written incorrectly, is that what this does is it actually doesn't iterate over every row. So at the aggregate level, it's saying take the max price, 4,000, and multiply by 8,000, and you're gonna get 35 million. So it doesn't work. So you need to do an iterative process below, not just the aggregate. And that's where max X. Max X, always think about iterate over every row. So let's show you how to do that correctly. And this is the bread and butter of max X. Max X total sale equals max X, so the sales table, and now we'll do an expression. I wanna know the sales price times the sales quantity. Enter, add this. Take this down, and voila, now it's working. So what it's still doing, just like the incorrect expression, is it is validating to the same row level, but not at the aggregate level, it's actually doing it correctly. It's saying, of all the orders within this, I'll perform this calculation on every row and then return the value. So within furniture, there's some total sale worth 55,000, 128, technology is 135. So overall, the highest sale across everything was $135,000. That's the difference between max X. It's for iterating over every single row. The final thing we'll look at is, let's also do this. It's always good to group and organize calculations. So as you can see, there's other groups here for other videos that are being created. Get this file from GitHub, but we're gonna do max and max X. The link's in the description. So the cool thing about this now is we'll look at this. If you're trying to build something where you need to have in a single calculation, pick the max between any values and return that. This is what you want to use for that. Here's what it looks like. So we'll just do an example that says, I want to return either the max price of whatever's larger from the price or the discount. I mean, it's always going to be the price, but this is just an example to show how it works. New measure, we'll do max between two scalar expressions. And so those are the important thing about this is that it's actually, you need to pick other calculations that this is computing. So it's not gonna look at the table. So you'll need to have like on the right-hand side, pick different calculations. So in this case, I'm gonna say max of the sum price, which is a function I've created or a calculation on the right-hand side, sum price. And we'll say that, or the sum discount. Whichever of those two is larger, return it. Do that, come here, formatting perspective. All right, so this is now working as well. It's just an example of how that max function can pick between two things. So it's searching and it's saying for every single thing, is this value higher, the max price or the max discount? Whichever is higher, return it. And that's how that works. That's how the idea between two expressions. So if this is helpful, take a minute, hit subscribe. There's lots more videos on DAX, lots on Power BI as well. Thanks for watching. Have a good one. Bye.